Hello, everyone, and welcome to Fearless Friday. My name is Dr. Benjamin Ritter, Leadership and Empowerment Coach at Live For Yourself Consulting, where we coach and guide individuals to create a career they can love. Today, I want to quickly go over some definitions of success and failure that have served me. But to talk about them, I need to talk about the definitions that are not serving people, maybe you. And so let's start with success. A lot of times people define success as accomplishing a specific goal they've set for themselves. And that's great, but it does leave you open to not achieving that. And so sometimes we don't take action because we're worried that we won't actually accomplish what we set out to do. So I'd like to take a look at success and say success is not achieving something specifically, but success is the reason why you are working towards it. So the meaning behind whatever your goal is. And then success becomes the application of those values and progress. Now, a lot of times we perceive failure as not actually achieving whatever we set out to work toward. So again, we have a certain expectation for ourselves, our definition of success. Failure is not achieving that. I'd like to reframe that again and say that failure is just the fact that we've taken action and that has led to a specific outcome. So failure in itself is action and knowledge, not actually the missing of the bullseye. It's not actually not achieving something. Failure in itself, again, is progress. So success and failure could actually be the same thing. They are progress. And if we change our definition to be that success and failure are the application of our values to learn and to grow, then we might actually take more action. We might be more motivated. We might be more engaged in what we're setting ourselves out to work towards. So can you look at maybe where you're doubting yourself or where you've paused and are not actually moving forwards in something that you care about and try to redefine success and failure as progress, as taking action, as learning, and hopefully really just living true to how you want to define yourself in your work and at life. So I want to hear from you. If this helps out, if you've taken one thing away, if you have some questions, just reach out to me. And most importantly, everyone, keep on living for yourself.